All right, we'll get started just a few minutes early. The time now is 5:57. I am Kimberly M. Starks, accredited public relations practitioner and principal consultant of the specialist communications firm Blue Scorpion Reputation Management. Tonight, we are in for a treat. We have Christian Kunkel here this evening with us. He is the University Partnerships of Nerd Street Gamers. He'll be talking tonight about chart-topping productions in esports, more specifically, the impact of esports on college campuses. Thank you so much for joining us this evening, Christian.
Thanks for having me.
So let's take a step back. Nerd Street Gamers, you all are located in Pennsylvania.
Based in Philadelphia.
Okay. And you all provide both a physical space and a virtual space. Tell us more about Nerd Street Gamers.
Yeah. So Nerd Street is an esports infrastructure company that is bringing competitive opportunities to the masses. And we do that in a bunch of different ways. So the first is the facility. So I mentioned, you know, providing those access points for local teams to come play and compete, for individuals to come, you know, participate in events and rent time on PCs. You know, we kind of are that souped up LAN center that gives those kinds of opportunities. We have facilities all across the country. So though we're based in Philadelphia, we are coast to coast now. We're in California, St. Louis, Texas, you know, a few spaces in Philadelphia, and we're growing really rapidly. So many more of those will be on the way. And that's a big part of our growth at the moment. On top of that, once you have a facility, they don't run themselves and they don't also draw people in themselves. You have to be very, very intentional and thoughtful about building your community and providing those kinds of events and programming. So we run lots and lots of events. That happens both in person and, like you mentioned, online as well. Certainly during COVID, we've had to move all of our operations online, like many in the industry have. Gaming has the, you know, the benefit of being able to do that, unlike many other industries. So we certainly have seen a lot of growth and a lot of interest in what we do over this last year, because we've been able to increase our reach geographically, and anyone can play, not just those that are around our facilities. We're very excited to get back in person, like many of the rest of us in the industry are, but we'll continue to run those online events. And that includes things like weeklies that are, you know, around specific games, that it's your community and you're there on a weekly basis. Maybe you're a Smash Brothers player and that you're there every Wednesday night because you have a small Smash tournament. But then we also run a structured amateur series all the way throughout the year. So we have a winter and summer championships, and you have weeklies, monthlies leading up to a kind of an amateur national championship of sorts. And we do that in a number of different titles. So we play really all the games. We're game agnostic. We like to support any community that already exists and wants to come together and play. As an infrastructure company, we're very flexible in that way. And then we work closely with the publishers to make sure that we're doing it at their standard and their level, and that they kind of give us the ability to kind of run those events. And then the third piece of it is the content side. So we're very, just like, you know, the rest of the growth of the industry, you see a lot of that happening on the content end. So we produce content, both original content about video gaming and competitive gaming, and then also produce a lot of content around our events. So we can do that, you know, through those championships, but we also work with many organizations and can kind of partner with them. Riot's one of them that we're operating a Valorant series for them right now, the Champions Tour. So we're very closely aligned with the publishers and kind of work all the way from the lowest amateur levels, young kids under 10 years old, we run camps for in the summer, all the way up to the pro levels, which we're producing pro level tournaments.